I'm a founder of a small firm called Plaything Transform, wherein we look at play for purpose and bringing in Lego serious play and gamification for businesses and individuals to solve problems. And prior to doing this, I was in the space of business process management, customer experience design, design thinking. So let's get started with the session for today. We're going to look at critical thinking. We're going to look at how does it matter. And we're getting into a small gameplay on applying design thinking. This gameplay is going to be a very dipstick small simulation to give a sense and understanding of what critical thinking brings on board when we try to apply it. So when we look at critical thinking by definition means the ability to understand the different connections between ideas, the ability to identify, construct, and evaluate different perspectives and different lines of thoughts, and thereupon detect inconsistencies or common approaches. So critical thinking in general, in a broader view, is looking at bringing different perspectives of different people in the team or across different stakeholders and trying to understand their perspectives. And from there, gleaning insights which would matter us a lot with regards to solving problems or applying it in different capacities. We would be looking today in the capacity of solving problems. Why is critical thinking important? So if you look at the World Economic Forum top 10 list of 2020, critical thinking stands second. So this is a list created interviewing the topmost CEOs of various different organizations, and they come up with critical thinking as a key skill for employees to bring to the organization. Now, for the gameplay today, we are going to look at a scenario, a sample scenario. Critical thinking can be applied on any scenario. We're looking at a sample scenario so that it is customizable and applicable for all of us over here, and we can correlate to it. And we have a small game on applying critical thinking. The scenario we are looking at is a handover transition of operations of IT project from one team or vendor to another team or vendor. It could be within an organization from one team to other team, or it could be between one team and the vendor, or it could be a vendor to vendor. The nuances of the two different team does not matter. The perspective of transition of operations team is important. So let's see at complex problems involved in transition operation, which has underlying aspects of people factor, business factor, and process factor. So for this gameplay, I'm going to call out a few people, and they would be playing this game, and we would be kind of demonstrating it, how it goes by. For the benefit of time, this is how we're going to do it, but otherwise we would have allowed to get all of you to play the game, which would require more time. So we're going to look at four critical thinking constructs today. The four constructs in the gameplay. The first construct is identifying constraint. Constraints here basically look at limitation of systems or framework which could limit the delivery or deliverable. The next construct is identifying roadblock. Roadblocks are sudden. They are they could be internal or external interruptions. And as they are sudden, they could be unknown or they could be new identified blind spots. The third critical thinking concept we're going to look at is value perception of the customer. This is more to look at what is the customer perceiving about the value being delivered before, during, as well as post the delivery. And the fourth we are going to look at is the value proposition of the service provider. What is the interpretation of the service provider of the value for the delivery that they are delivering? For this gameplay, we're going to have a one small iteration of the gameplay using these four constructs. Normally, this gameplay has four different phases. We are just looking at one iteration of the first phase. I'll invite the following teams to come on board. So team one would be represented by Jyotika and Rohit, who would be representing a customer bank in this transition operation. And team two would be Milan and Murali, who would be representing the service provider of an IT company. And I'm going to go off the presentation and open the mural board on which we're going to play the game. Can I just get a feedback if the mural board is visible?
Yes, it is visible.
Perfect. Thanks, Sarvet. So this game is called Trick-Tac-Toe, wherein it starts with identifying three common problem areas under the given problem statement for which we would want to apply the critical thinking areas. We have pre-identified three common problems under the transition operations, they being culture mindset, skill gaps between two teams, and collaboration. Normally, these three problem areas are contextual, and the team, whoever is playing, every time the game play, they have to replace this and identify what is contextual in that moment of time for that day. Here we are bringing up simpler problems such as correlatable for all of us and try to see how critical thinking can be applied for it. Now, I'll request the two teams to help and play, and I'm going to just be a proxy for them, play on the table on their behalf. So the customer, that is a bank, would be represented by yellow, the X cards. The service provider, that is IT company, would be represented by the green cards. Now, how this gameplay involves is we play a normal tic-tac-toe game on this board with these cards. And these cards have these four constructs and some blank cards hidden behind it. The first stage, we'll play the game. The second stage, we'll identify the problem that needs to be, that is shortlisted because of this game. And then we'll flip these cards, and the two teams would try to apply these constructs on these cards to trigger different thought processes, possible ideas, solutions, and approaches. With this, I'll invite the teams to start playing and guide me how to play so that I can move these pieces on the board for you on your behalf. So Rohit, Jitika, Melin, and Mulli, over to you. Who would want to go first? Which team would want to go first and take the first shot at the tic-tac-toe game?
All right. So we as a bank want to propose the first card.
Okay, perfect. Sure. Okay. Where should I place this card?
So we'll go with one.
Okay. Perfect. Okay. Moving to the service provider team, where should I place your card? The next card.
Yeah, we will go with nine.
Okay.
Jyotika,
the take customer team.
Yeah, let's go with two.
Okay. Moving on to the service provider green team.
Yeah, we'll go with five.
Okay.
The what about team? Six, Jyotika?
Yep.
Six.
No, eight, sorry, okay.
Eight.
Okay. The service provider team.
Yeah, we'll go with six.
Sure.
Yeah, seven for us.
Yeah, we'll go with four.
The service provider.
Yeah,
four. Okay. Perfect.
I mean, there's only one left.
One last cell. Yeah. So this has brought us into a draw board. And normally in a critical complex problem, quite often we end up into deadlock. This draw board is depicting a deadlock situation. Now, we played the tic-tac-toe game to randomize the problem we would be addressing and applying this critical constructs for this iteration. So how do we identify which problem we are going to address? So the problem gets identified by the last card which ends the game. For us, the last card ended this game. So it is in row number three. So that brings us to problem number three, which is collaboration. So we'll look at applying these constructs onto collaboration. I'll quickly flip these cards and then I'll zoom in for all of you to have a look at it. And then we'll get into the next part of the gameplay. Thank you. So this is how we are getting the board as. So the constructs we have flipped up and randomized this for the service provider team. The constructs comes value propose perception of the customer and identifying constraints. Whereas for the customer team, we have the cards, which is identifying constraints and identifying roadblocks. Okay, so now let's try to look at this application of these in the problem statement area of collaboration for transition operations. So while the teams are bringing up and ideating, I'll also invite the audience to come up and participate. And if you have any ideas for this team, you can start pasting it onto the chat as well.
Prashant here, can you enlarge the screen, please?
Sure.
Thank you.
Let me know if it is visible or not. And I'm also putting it on the chat as well.
So can we start giving the inputs or
Yes, so for the input.
Okay, so for collaboration, the constraint could be the time zone difference or timeline could be another constraint to complete the transition in the given time.
Okay.
Availability of key stakeholders.
Okay.
Yeah, availability of proper documentation in terms of user manual and maintenance manual.
Okay.
Extra effort which is required from the employees to get used to the new system.
Okay.
Familiarity with the domain.
Okay.
Roadblock could be the infrastructure availability.
So roadblocks of infrastructure?
Yeah.
Okay. So whatever is on top of your mind, just bring it across. We are not just looking at the right answer. We're just looking at all positives over here, all possibilities over here of applying these constructs. We might not know whether they would work or not, but it's so perfectly okay to think in those lines.
Understanding each other's strengths and weaknesses.
Could be reluctance to share knowledge.
Okay. And even the audience, they can join in. We are looking at the critical thinking constructs of these four, which have been flipped for the customer and the service provider. If there are anything put on the chat by the audience, do read it out so that I can put it across. Okay. Any other thought? Last. Half a minute, 30 seconds more. Do you have any other possibilities coming up? We're looking at collaboration for a transition.
Yeah, ego between the associates.
Okay.
Hierarchical differences.
Okay.
I think we can add one more point also, that is attitudes.
Okay.
Attitude towards adapting to the new system.
Okay. You have the last 10 seconds for your last check.
whoever
5 seconds
whoever leading the team, they are not giving an opportunity to other team members. They are not giving not opportunity. Opportunity.
Okay. Okay. Perfect. Do we need another minute or more? We are almost over with the time frame. Do you need another minute or half a minute? No, oh, are we good enough over here?
I think we are good enough because okay. I don't see.
Perfect. So what we have done is I'm just zooming out. You may not be able to read it, but I'm just zooming out to give you a perspective of what happened. In just 5 minutes, both the teams could bring out their perspective areas where possible ideas, solutions, or approaches can be brought in for a better collaboration in transition operations. And we have got these many ideas on board. Almost 15 ideas in 3 minutes of thinking on this. The first 2 minutes went about playing the board game to randomize the problem and randomize the constructs. And this is the first iteration. We have got around 13 to 14 possible approaches, solutions, or ideas on board. So when we look at critical thinking, the essence is initially to bring out all these perspectives off. How are we doing on time? Should we do we have time for the next iteration, or should we move on further to the next step of retrospective and Q&A?
We have good enough time. How much time the next iteration take?
We can do it another the next iteration in 3 minutes time. Is it okay? Shall we give it a try?
Yeah, we can.
Okay.
We can wrap it up at 10:25.
Perfect.
Maximum.
So going back to the team, this time I'll let the green team to start. I'm just using these cards, moving these cards back without flipping them. So it's okay because we are just doing it faster.
So bank and IT team, pick up your cards quicker.
Yeah. So we'll start with the IT team. Where do you want me to place a board?
Four.
Okay. Going to the bank now. Where do you want to place it?
9.
Okay.
One.
Perfect. Sure.
8.
Okay, 8.
5.
For the bank team?
2.
Okay.
3.
Okay, 7.
Okay, 7. And we left with 1, and this goes to a win board. Okay. Now, here's an interesting aspect. The row number 2 got the last card, so we're looking at now skill gaps between two teams. In a win board, what happens is we would just look at the cards which are in the win row or win file. And both the teams are going to just use these cards and apply their particular let me ungroup it first. Okay, I'll come back to this one quickly. Okay, I guess we just have a blank card here, so I'll move this card over here. Okay, for skill gap between two teams, the two constructs we have got is value proposition of the service provider and value perception of the customer. So what's the value proposition of the service provider with regards to skills being offered, and what's the value perception of the customer with regards to the skills on the table that is being required? So both the teams, you can start coming up with ideas or possibilities.
Okay, so from the audience
can, yeah, go ahead.
So from the value proposition of the customer, I would say first point is they would definitely want the team to be prepared for a quick transformation.
Okay.
Because I don't think any company would be interested to spend money with respect to for the time training them.
Okay, we're just bringing out the thought process. We are not explaining or reasoning them. So go on to the next.
Technical lead is doing all team members' work without enhancing their skill set or giving the KT. No, here technical lead, not technical team. Technical lead.
Okay, the other value proposition is domain expertise on the vendor side.
Domain expertise on vendor side. Okay, what else?
No opportunity for skill set improvement.
Okay.
And there are no opportunities for certifications. Because it is a fixed price project.
Okay.
Past experiences of similar nature.
Past experiences of similar nature. Okay.
Legacy technology resources not available.
Okay, what else?
Lesser cost.
Lesser cost or lesser calls?
Lesser cost of doing the transition in lesser cost, yeah.
Okay, perfect.
Confusion related to the implementation plan.
Okay. We just have another 45 seconds.
Solution ambiguity before doing any work.
Okay, solution ambiguity
before starting the work.
Okay.
Automated tools to reduce efforts, manual efforts.
Clear sign offs could be clear ways of signing off KT's mechanism for that.
Okay. What else? But
confuse attention to technical excellence.
Okay.
No breach of information security related issues. Adherence to that will be another value proposition.
Last 10 seconds. 5 seconds now. Anything that comes up on top of your mind?
Too many overheads. Sure. To prepare a solution ambiguity. To clear the solution ambiguity.
Okay, we'll stop here because we are now at 10:26. We'll stop here. Now, again, we've got almost this row full up for all these particular problem statements. I'll later on copy it and share it with the organizers so that you can get it. But with just 3 minutes of play, we're looking at almost two-thirds of ideas with regards to two different common areas of problem by applying critical thinking. So that's what we wanted to demonstrate, the essence of critical thinking and how it helps us get into solving problems. So. Thanks a lot to both the teams for helping me play and sportingly playing here. To Jitika, Rohit, Melan, Murali, and thanks a lot to all those who were reading out or coming up with their possibilities and solutions. This does not stop here. This was just the first experience of getting you to get in the space of critical thinking. Okay, now let's get into the retrospective or key takeaways from the small simulation of gameplay that we have looked at. For each one of you, including the audience, how do you see critical thinking tying back to agile software development? Please use the chat to type in and put it in the chat, whoever is having anything. And for the players, if you have, you can even speak out. I'll try to put them into the mural board here. I'll just use the short forms of these things to just put up what all thoughts come out with regards to retrospective. The floor is open now. We have a good amount of how much percent we have time of 10 minutes now. Yeah,
we have 10:37. We can in 35, and then last 15 minutes we can do the Q&A with the audience. Till 10:35, time for the second takeaway.
Perfect. 7 minutes. Where all do you think critical thinking ties back to the agile software development? And from this gameplay and simulation, what comes to your mind?
Yeah, so it can be used for ideation, brainstorming. It can be used in retrospective meetings.
Okay, brainstorming.
It is very useful, whichever the things we have discussed, we have to take action. I mean to say action items.
Okay.
We have to prepare and we have to close those action items with a certain time box.
Okay.
Gamification helps in inducing more active participation.
Gamification helps in inducing, okay, it's in the chat, I'll pick it up from there.
Addressing impediments.
Detailed
can the audience be a little louder, please? The audience, little louder.
Yeah.
The detailed discussion.
Detailed discussion.
Detailed discussion is necessary to understand each and every person's mindset and creating that to get the desired results.
Yeah, I think it also creates psychological safety. I think it helps people speak up. So. You get to hear every voice and it's kind of an equalizer. There's no hierarchy. So that's one good thing about it, I think.
Somebody was also talking about impediments. If I missed it out, do let me know.
Breaking the 80-20 rule to make it 100-100 is very necessary. And this tool helps that, doing that.
Yeah.
Teams may need a few iterations to be able to effectively use this tool.
Teams will need few iterations, yeah.
To effectively use this tool.
Team ideas and buy-in. I'm picking up from the chat. Prioritize requirement. Okay.
Visualization helps the team to perform better.
You summed it up nicely, Rohit. That's what I was trying to convey.
Okay, wonderful. Ownership and responsibility. Okay. What else? If I missed anything in the chat, do help me, Prashant. I'm also keeping it, but if anything is missed out, do let me know.
Yeah, I think communication, collaboration across the team may improve with playing this game because you're involving everybody. So kind of joint ownership sort of, it will convey that message. Collective okay. Ownership, yeah.
Okay.
Workflow management improvement.
And Anil V has mentioned that we get better buy-ins.
Yeah. Okay. I guess I'll leave it alone, but still I'll put it across. There's no harm having duplicates. I'll rationalize it. Okay.
Risk mitigation.
Shared vision and shared ownership is improves the team productivity as well as trust.
Shared vision, and I could not get the last one. Second word, shared something.
Shared ownership.
Ownership. Okay. Okay.
Management visibility.
Higher participation with better prospects from the participants.
Self-organized team from chat, I'm picking it up. This transparency as well. Yeah, go ahead.
Inculcate a different yet inclusive way of working.
Prioritization management.
We have 2 minutes left, Lakshman.
Sure. I'm just picking up some aspects from the chat as well, which I missed out. Okay. Any last thoughts on the retrospective? We still have a minute. If any thoughts, we'll work on it. So go ahead.
Bring transparency and change.
Transparency and? I could not hear the last part of this sentence. Transparency and something.
She said transparency in meetings.
Okay.
Will work well in will work well even in distributed teams and remote working.
Okay.
I think and it'll be it will have this fun element that will be very nice. So something, you know, in a little informal and fun way, so people. That is, I think, very good.
Okay, we are at 10:35. I'll stop typing here, but if you have anything, you can keep on that. We'll move on to the Q&A session. This does not stop you from bringing out all your retro thoughts on the chat. Feel free to do that. Okay, so we'll move on to the Q&A part. So any questions, feel free to type it in the chat and I'll request Shreya to pick it up and read it out so that I can respond to all of those chats. Shreya, you're on mute, I guess.
Yes, I can read those out for you. So far there's one. So Padmaja Kulkarni is asking, can you please share online version of this game, as it certainly looks helpful given we all are work from home now.
Okay, there's an online version of this game which is on mural board. Now what happens is this is a facilitated game, so we need to introduce this game somebody also in the retrospective mentioned this requires certain iteration for the team to adapt, so that is where the facilitation happens, and it also requires certain amount of onboarding on the mural board. So once that is done, there is this online version through mural board which can be available. I hope this answers Padmanja's question.
All right. How about the website link? People are also asking for the website link, if you could. So probably after this, you can, I can type it here after this session.
Perfect. Yeah. The website is the website of my organization. It does not has the, there's no specific website for this game, but we have mural boards, which is customized, and we share the links to concerned people who require it and they can use it.
Okay. Any more questions from the audience?
Lakshman, one thing I want to ask. Leadership, they are very, very hesitate to participate these kind of events. Why? Because they will say, we don't want retro. If you have any concerns, please write an email to us. We will look into.
Yeah.
Okay. So how to bring the speed in the leadership to part, we need to request, and they have to participate voluntarily. And they are saying, if we participate, okay, you are bringing all the problems, you are not bringing solutions. That again, question to facilitator. Okay, so how we can convince them? Okay, for example, it's a beautiful game. I am very impressed playing this game as a participant. But if I convey the same information to my leader, okay, they are saying, oh, you are bringing all the problems. That means you are cornering me. Like that, they are thinking in negative way.
Mm-hmm. True. Very, very valid fact. Okay, there are two factors to the response. One is critical thinking is something that need not be applied only for a specific thing. It has to be the way of life. Once we bring critical thinking to way of life, then for leaders, for team members, irrespective of hierarchy, this becomes a part and parcel of the day. Second is, this is where gamification helps. Now, this game is so designed that this can be introduced in a team huddle or on a Friday evening in the cafeteria. This can be played just as a small team play, fun team play element. Now, whenever we say we are going to have a game play, this does not stop us from getting the leaders or anybody not interested in it. Rather than going and inviting them, just bring it out of the board, open it, and get them to get involved. So anybody likes to play. If there's a formal invitation to play, definitely there will be a reluctance. And play reduces this psychological safety, as somebody mentioned, over different hierarchies, over different expertise. And that's the reason why I prefer to look into a lot of play-based interventions to get people to immediately jump into it.
Okay, thank you so much.
One more question to continue the previous question. Okay, so how to send the invite to the leadership team? For example, if I'm having Agile coach hat, okay, so how to send an invite to participate in this game? Do you have any tips and tricks?
Okay, I don't have any tips and tricks. What I do have is looking at the leaders' key concern areas and trying to get them to focus on those areas and link it to the work that we are doing. Every work that the leader does is linked to what we are doing. And from there, bringing it. It's definitely a gradual process, but definitely it helps on taking over there.
Okay. It is applicable for fixed price projects also. I mean to say, whichever the operating model, I mean to say, but cost is fixed price. So so here, if we follow safe, lean, Kanban, blah, blah, blah. Okay. But here project is fixed price. So, you know, right, in fixed price project, we don't want to showcase how we are performing to the end customer. Mm-hmm. At the end, we have to do the deliverable. So in this exercise, there are a lot of challenges will come to senior delivery manager or delivery manager or business unit heads. Mm-hmm. Okay, so they are not thinking about people issues. Okay, so they will think delivery.
Right. Okay. When we are talking about group of people meeting together, let me put it this way, irrespective of its fixed price or its T&M, when group of people are meeting together, they are spending a lot of time together. And the essence is not to create extra time. The essence is utilize a small portion of the time in a much more constructive, creative, productive manner. If we do that, there would always be room for getting more and more such things done. The perspective required is looking at group of people spending time together. How do we utilize a very small portion of the time without creating additional space for it?
Okay, thank you, Lakshman.
And I highly request attendees to please post their questions in the chat box. So there is one more question, Lakshman, from Anil V. He's asking Mural mm-hmm. versus Miro, or how different is this from Miro?
Okay, both are similar solutions by two different companies. When you look at Mural, it's quite open and quite good for public use because there are a lot of features which does not require signing up. Miro is good wherein you require data security, and off late during the COVID situation, Miro has improved a lot of its feature. So it's not a question one over the other, it's a question of in which context you want to use it.
Okay. All right. So another question from Sanjeev Sharma is, what is the best dashboard that can be used to share the project updates with all the stakeholders, both internal and external stakeholders?
I'm going to park this question. Sorry, I'm not a good expert in dashboards, so I might not be able to answer this question.
Okay. And moving on to Jyutika's question. Are there more mm-hmm. such games for distributed agile teams on your website?
Okay, we don't have off-the-shelf games. We do have templates of the game, which is like 70 to 80% ready. The remaining 20-30% is customized based on the team members and the context of the team that they're working on, and which takes into factor all these considerations, how distributed they are, how remote they are, what is the level of interactions they need, based on which we go and we customize the remaining 20-30% and then hand it over. So there's no off-the-shelf tools, but we do have various different games and tools with this regards. And I also okay. got a small question from Rohit asking me to talk about the minimum prerequisites for the player to play this game. The minimum prerequisite for this for the players to play this game is that the players need to have a common context, either as part of the team or as part of the project or as part of the module. And wherever the players or the team members are meeting together, we just need to create a space for them to play. Of course, they cannot play directly. What requires is we have two days of training facilitation on this game. We have just explored one phase of this game. We have multiple phases to look at, or four phases to look at. So that is covered in 2 days. And then the team can decide on their own and take it up and play it wherever they create time.
Okay. Okay. Priyanka Bharti is asking about, she wanted to know what tool used here for retrospective.
Okay, here we have just used a retrospective as an open-ended open plate, getting all of you to get in, and I've just posted it in the sticky notes. I've not created a tool. The tool wherein we were playing this is Mural. We don't have any specific framework that we had for the retrospective here, just for want of time. So we kept it open-ended because we had a limited time for the retrospective to be covered in such a big audience team.
Right.
Okay. And I do see a question on my website and other details. So let me possibly share my screen, which has the details, and you could look at it.
Sure.
Okay. I guess the window has closed. I can write it in chat. It's lakshman@playthingtransform.com, and the website is playthingtransform.com. If we have more questions, happy to take it up as well.
Yeah, there is one question from Rohit. What is the typical full session of this game?
Okay. As part of the initial onboarding, this is normally a two-day typical full session. But once the teams have, so it is recommended that teams play it at least once a week. And in that case, the full session is around 2 hours. And when the team gets to use to playing it daily, the typical full session is just 15 minutes. The reason being is the time defined is caters to the problem statements that we have brought on board. How recent they are, how detailed and contextual they are, and how important and critical they are to be explored.
Okay. All right. So I believe that's all for the questions.
Sure.
So thank you so much, Lakshman, for such an interactive session. It was
really impactful. Thank you, Shreya, and
thank you to all the participants.
Thank you, Shreya.
My pleasure.
Thank you, Lakshman.
Thank you, Lakshman.
You mean
minute. Thank you, Lakshman. Thank you, Murli.
Thanks for a wonderful everyone.
Great session, Lakshman. Thanks a lot.
Thank you, Jyotika, Lakshman, Murli, Milen, and Shreya. And thank you to the participants. We apologize for the glitch at the start. I think we're back on schedule here. Thank you once again. And have a nice day. Bye-bye. Join us again, please, at 11 o'clock.
So we would love to see you again at 11 o'clock for our upcoming session, which will be hosted by ANI Gurugram on how to enhance retrospective. And again, I recommend you to join a few minutes prior to the scheduled time. So just to maintain a smooth flow so that we start on time. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Shreya. You helped us come back on schedule. You did a wonderful job. In 6 minutes flat,
thank
I guess.
You
are a T10 player now.
All right, so probably we all can quickly go and get some tea or coffee. And then we'll see each other again in a couple of minutes.
In the same room, we can continue the session?
Yes, yes, it is going to be in the same room.
Okay, no need to left from the room, right?
No, you don't. It's not required to leave the room. You can just...
Okay. Yeah. Yes. Thank you, Shreya. Thank you.
Okay, Shreya.
Say something, Lakshman?
Yeah.
I'm still the presenter. If you could remove the presenter rights, that would be good enough. Because if I'm unknowingly, if I close the session, then
I'll do that. I don't think I can take those. Okay. All right. I think.